Mike Moses, lead pastor of Lake Forest Church here, coming to you from an auto dealership just the other side of I-77. This is where Lake Forest Church had its birth. This building was originally a skating rink. We started off worshiping here on a Sunday morning in 1998. Sometimes we call ourselves a rock and roll church. Let me tell you a little bit more about Lake Forest. We are in the Lake Norman area of Charlotte, North Carolina. That is the suburban area just north of Charlotte, and it's around a large recreational body of water called, oddly enough, Lake Norman. And today, Lake Forest is a church of anywhere from 1,600 to 2,300 souls. On a Sunday, our first church plant is now Lake Forest Church Davidson, is now over 300 people on a Sunday, and we rejoice at that. Many of those were formerly unchurched. Our next church plant will launch in January of 2014, and we're searching for the pastor for that, who will preach there right now. Fun facts about Lake Forest Church. For a decade now, we've sent at least 10% and up to 15% of our members on short-term cross-cultural mission trips every summer. We started with a core group of 42 people. One of our staff has titled her job Worship Arts Chick. If there's one single special hidden sauce about our church, it is the unique and successful dance of mutual submission between the senior pastor and the elders at our church. Another fun fact about Lake Forest Church, during our last capital campaign, 30% of the funds that we raised over 3 years were deployed outside the walls of this church building for mission and evangelism. At the core of Lake Forest Church is the mission to be witnesses for Jesus Christ to the tribe we're called to be missionaries to. That's the tribe of the Lake Norman part of Charlotte, specifically the unchurched people in the Lake Norman area of Charlotte, North Carolina. We refer to them as people who've given up on church but haven't given up on God. And every Sunday, when we welcome people to worship, we say we welcome all of you, and every week we worship as skeptics, spiritual explorers, and people who've been following Jesus together for many years. And so we're glad you're here to worship no matter where you are in your spiritual journey. We are 3 years into a 10-year vision to become a multiplying church. That at the end of 10 years, if you scratch us, one of the things that would just bleed out of us would be we multiply congregations. In addition to tithing our annual budget to missions, our elders have now set aside 3% annually of our budget into a church planting fund, ensuring that we will be about church multiplication at Lake Forest for the long haul. A year and a half ago, we launched a daughter church slash campus. It's a hybrid. It utilizes the efficiencies of being one church but two campuses, which are many. We're now one church worshiping in two locations with a live teaching pastor in both campuses. And I and Michael Flake, who's the campus pastor of our daughter campus, we switch teaching every 5 to 6 weeks. So we call ourselves an ancient future church. We worship in a very future-oriented way. We speak the predominant musical language of the culture, adult progressive rock and roll. But we are on a journey of going back and recapturing and reinterpreting ancient Christian worship practices from many Christian traditions into our modern worship service. And so that includes elements like the Lord's Prayer, the Apostles' Creed, of course, which many churches are like, duh, you should have been doing that all along. Well, that's not a duh statement for contemporary worship kind of churches. And we're trying to correct that and root our people more deeply in these ways. We observe Lent now annually. We've done so for 4 years, beginning with an Ash Wednesday service that this year we shared with an Orthodox Anglican church in the community. in spiritual formation as a congregation, we decided to ramp up our discipleship, particularly at the deep end of the pool. And so our spiritual formation pastor, Mitch White, pioneered a partnership with Gordon Conwell Seminary to offer the biblical theology classes to the leaders in our congregation. And we've now done that for a year and a half in partnership with three other churches here in the north part of Charlotte. Every church has its own unique, beautiful reflection as a bride of Christ. One of the beauties of this bride of Christ, we think, is a clear focus on Jesus. We try to communicate that this is about Jesus. It's not first and foremost about morality or an institution or religion or all of us being of one political stripe or making my family work or any host of other things. It's really about Jesus. And one of the ways that our elders and leaders came to communicate that a few years ago is we reformulated our core values around Jesus. And so we say them like this. Here are our core values. We will welcome who Jesus welcomed, people who've given up on church but not on God. We will love like Jesus with grace and truth. We will live like Jesus, always on the Missio Dei, or the mission of God. We will journey like Jesus, doing life together. And the last core value is we will lead like Jesus toward more and better disciples, leaders, and churches. We have the aspiration at Lake Forest to be a both and church. It gets messy, it gets gray, and sometimes we're more of one and less of the other, but we aspire to be both an attractional and a missional church. Maybe the most clear example of being an attractional church for us is every 2 years we do a focal point sermon series that we call Hope in a House of Blues, where we experiment with a mashup of the blues that we all have in this world, blues music. We bring in national and internationally acclaimed blues and gospel artists, and then we mash that up with our existing worship leaders and liturgy, and then we cover it all over with preaching from the Word of God, a blues text like Lamentations or the Tribulation. And it is a beautiful, palpable month in the life of our church. In fact, right now we're in the middle of that series, and our artists have made our sanctuary this year. Their artistic theme was to look like a 20th century old small town theater. So an example of being a missional church is really played out in our current very concrete vision, our long-term vision. Our vision is very clear, and it is textual to Acts 1:8, where Jesus said, "You will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and to the ends of the earth." Another example of being a missional church is the fact that out of our last capital campaign, we created a neighborhood redevelopment foundation. We seeded it with $500,000. And basically, we are investing ourselves relationally into loving on the people of a neighborhood that's just a mile away from our building that has a massive amount of social and spiritual need. The neighborhood is predominantly a mobile home park. So our Acts 1:8 vision is one more person that we'll reach in our Jerusalem, one more church that we will plant in our Judea and the ends of the earth, one more neighborhood that we will love in the name of Jesus in our Samaria, and one more leader who we will raise up at a time to do ministry inside and outside of our church. That's our vision. Everybody gets it. It's one more. So that's a bit of a description of the ways that we are trying to live out the tension of being an attractional and a missional church simply in the image of Jesus' ministry when He was on earth. Some more fun facts about Lake Forest. When we built this building, we put showers in the worship center bathrooms so that we could do what we do now, which is we are an overflow homeless shelter in our building. We partner with other churches in a local mission every December that we call the Christmas Village Toy Store. Long story short, we take out everything out of the worship center, and for one weekend, our worship center becomes the largest toy store north of uptown Charlotte. This year, we were able to serve hundreds of low-income families who were able to purchase toys at a very reduced price, and then the money that they paid for the toys, we turned around and gave to the local food bank. The heart of discipleship at Lake Forest is in our community group ministry. We encourage every adult to be part of a community group, either evenings meeting in homes with mixed men and women, couples and singles, or a men's group or a women's group studying the scriptures together. And we tie a lot of those groups into discussions out of the sermon weekly. As your host, we're really honored to be nominated for the Bart Hess Award as a congregation. Really honored.